Hello, I'm Andy. Welcome to my show. It's my show, not your show. You're going to have to deal with that, not me. As regular viewers will know here on Andy, we aim to help solve the problems that have torn families apart. The problems that have led to children not seeing their mother or father and other problems, whatever. So with that said, let's move on to today's topic. Teenage pregnancy is an issue that has affected the United Kingdom for a long time. It's been so bad that we have even the highest teenage pregnancy rates in Europe, and that's including Germany. It's this situation that our first guest, Katie, finds herself in. So please welcome Katie to the show. Katie, everyone. Katie.
Hi.
Welcome to the show. Explain to us your story.
Well, I was going out with Lee, and then we broke up. On that break, I slept with some other people. Now I'm pregnant, and I don't know who the dad is.
Right. Why were you on a break?
Apparently, I'm controlling and a bit overbearing. Mm. Apparently, his friend said that I'd changed him. I don't know why. I'm so nice.
We'll talk to your boyfriend in a second, but I just want to ask you just a quick question. You can't have been that upset about your breakup, because then you went and slept with not just one, but two other blokes.
I don't really want to hear you
speak, because it makes my ears hurt. So before you're allowed to say anything, we're going to bring out your boyfriend, Lee. Lee, everyone, please welcome him. Lee.
Hi.
Welcome to the show.
Thank you.
Let's just recap then. Katie says that you broke up because she's too controlling. Is that true?
Yeah, it is all the time. She uses me as a doormat. She steps all over me. It used to be about us two. Now it's just her. I don't know what's wrong with her.
Lee, have you got a backbone?
I do. It's just she's too controlling. It's her.
Do you actually stand up for yourself at any point in the process at all?
Well, you know...
You don't, do you? Let's be honest. No, you don't, because you're a bit of a wuss. Have you got a job, Lee?
I do.
What do you do?
I'm a bin man.
You're a bin man?
Yeah.
It's good. It's a British job.
Thank you.
What I like.
Thank you.
You're the reason we've got a British empire. Good man. All right, if she's too controlling, why are you still together?
Guess love. I love her.
It's fair enough. Lee, what are you going to do if the baby's yours?
Well... What can I do? I'm going to stand by it.
Do you think the baby is yours?
I hope so.
You hope so?
I hope so.
You need a bit more than hope. Katie, who else then did you sleep with when you were on this break?
Well, I slept with Lee, obviously, and my ex, Barry, and Lee's best mate, Dave.
Dave?
Lee. Lee, did you know about this?
No. How can you sleep with my best friend?
Does this change things between you, see?
Well, not with the baby. If the baby's mine, I'll stick by it. But how can you sleep with Dave?
It just happened.
All right, tell you what, let's just keep it nice and chilled. Let's bring out Lee's best friend, Dave. Welcome Dave to the show, please.
Lie.
How could you?
What? You're a liar.
How could you sleep with my girlfriend?
Dave.
You're right, Andy.
You say that she's lying. Why are you saying that?
Because I didn't sleep with her.
Well, according to her, that you did sleep with her.
Yeah, well, she's lying.
Are you calling my girlfriend a liar?
Yeah, because I didn't sleep with her, mate.
Yeah, you
would
did.
I do
sure.
that to you? Would
yeah,
I do
you did.
That to you?
Dave, quick question.
She said
you
did.
Yeah, what? What's wrong with your face?
Got a little bit messy last night.
Messy last night? In what sort of way?
Had a few drinks. Some guy looked at me funny. Showed him what's what. He got a few lucky hits in. No big deal.
Do you think that's a way for a... If the baby's yours, do you think that's a way for a dad to
mine,
behave?
So I ain't no dad. Don't matter. Do what
I want. Have you got a job, Dave?
Pardon?
Have you got a job?
I'm between jobs at the moment.
Between jobs, so you're unemployed.
It's credit crunch on, you know.
Unemployed equals scum. Regular viewers will know that we put every guest through a lie detector. The results are as follows. When asked if you slept with Katie over this break, you said no to the test.
It's because I didn't.
The test said... That you'd lied, Dave.
No.
Oh, how could you?
The machine's broken, mate. I'm telling you.
No.
The machine's wrong.
It's a lie
wrong.
Detector.
It's wrong.
It doesn't lie.
It's wrong. The lie detector's lying.
Dave, are you not mad enough to admit that you've done something wrong and that you've put your best friend through...
God.
That's a harsh way to treat your best friend, isn't it, Dave?
Didn't touch her. Did not
you
touch
didn't
yes,
touch
you
her.
Yes, you
did. I didn't.
Yes, you did, though.
I didn't.
All right, yeah, all right, okay.
That's
right.
Not hard.
Shut it! Oh. We've established then that Katie is pregnant. She has a boyfriend called Lee. Bit of a sap, but we'll carry on. During this break that they were on, Katie slept with Lee's best friend, Dave. She also slept with her ex, Barry. We've heard from Lee and Dave. So now let's bring out Lee. No, we've already brought out Lee. That's not the point. Tell you what. Let's bring out Barry. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Barry. Welcome, Barry.
Andy.
So, explain to me what happened between you and Katie.
Well, we were dating 6 months back, and it was the best 6 months. And she broke up with me to go out with Lou.
Because you're an idiot.
And then when they broke up, she came straight back to me, and just she said that she loved me and she wanted.
You're a liar. I never said that I loved him.
You never said that you loved him?
Oh. Stop lying. You said you... Oh, God.
Barry, put yourself together. Have you got a job?
No, I suffer from depression.
Suffer from depression? Have you seen anyone about it?
No.
You got help?
I've got...
Do you want help?
No, I'll take...
Do you need help?
I'll take...
Do you want help?
I'll see tomorrow.
Do you want some help? We can give you some help.
I'll have some help.
Good.
Lift.
So now we know everyone who's been involved in this saga. Let's get to the serious part of the show. We've got a very silly girl who slept with three other blokes. She doesn't know who the father is, and she came on to this show to find out. We've done a paternity test. Barry, what are you going to do if the kid's yours?
Well, obviously...
It's not his.
It is.
It's not his.
You can move into
let Barry talk, yeah?
You can move into my house. I'll make you breakfast all the time.
I don't want to move into your house.
I'll move there.
I don't want your breakfast.
Okay, whatever. Dave, what are you going to do if the kid's yours?
Not mine.
Good. Just not yours?
I hope not.
Not mine.
I hope not.
Lee, what are you going to do if the kid's yours?
Well, I'm not being funny. I said it before. I'll stand by the kid.
What about me?
Katie, who do you want the father to be?
I want it to be Lee.
Right, okay. Let's find out then. We've taken this.
No, Barry.
We've taken this. We've taken this paternity test. Tell you what. Let's read out the results. The paternity test showed that the father of Katie's baby is Lee.
Oh.
Lee, how are you feeling?
Ecstatic.
Tell you what, Lee, we want you to be able to provide the best sort of environment for your unborn kid. We're going to send you backstage with...
Barry.
Barry, I'm talking, I'm pretty, you're ugly. Face facts. Tell you what, we're going to send you backstage, go and have a chat with our psychiatrist, Glenn. Ladies and gentlemen, please thank Lee for coming onto the show. Lee, everyone.
Barry.
You're off the stage.
Boys, yeah. you've both acted pretty well, horrifically towards this girl. Barry, I'm seriously concerned about your mental health. We're going to get you some professional help because we think you need it, potentially
I
a facelift as well.
Something
that would have sorted this whole situation out is if you hadn't had sex, if you'd have just kept it in your trousers. You took advantage of someone who was at a very difficult point in their lives.
She took advantage of me.
And you took advantage of them.
She took advantage of me.
I don't
both
think that's true. No. No.
I'm talking. No, shut your face. Both of you, off the stage. I don't want to look at you anymore. You're both despicable human beings. Thank them for coming onto the show, everyone.
Go.
Get off, Barry. Right, Katie, you know who the father is?
Yeah.
You know full well that you're going to have to look after this kid.
Yeah.
Are you ready for this responsibility?
I am, yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
You going to make a go of it?
I am. I'm going to do it well.
Well, I wish you all the best of luck. Please thank Katie for coming on the show. Katie, everyone. Right, so we've all learnt a little bit from this, and here's a little final thought for you. I'm fit and you're not. How do you cope with that? Remember, if you've got any issues and you can't discuss them in the privacy of your own home like a normal person, please call the show so we can all judge you on national television. Thanks very much for joining us. We'll see you next time. Thanks now. Bye.
The rain, 'cause we'll get through it anyway. We'll get up and